So we've got our 2011 Ford F-Series 350 Super Duty 6.7 liter diesel engine. And I was driving down the road and I heard a loud I wasn't entirely sure what it was, but I did lose power. The truck was sort of limping along at that point. Cracked the hood open and looked in here, and lo and behold, this factory intercooler hose that Ford installed is blown. And if you take a good look at it right there, you can see where the pipe has become separated. So I hear this is a fairly common problem. There's supposed to be about 25 PSI that runs through that turbo. The replacement part, a factory replacement part for another plastic pipe is $169 or so off of eBay. You can spend another 20, 30, 40, 50, how much ever, and get a metal version that replaces it as well. I went ahead on eBay, in fact, and ordered the plastic replacement for it. It does have the sensor built into it, and so we'll go ahead and go through replacing it. But before we get there, we're gonna run inside the truck, crank it up, and let you have a look at what it looks like when that happens. Now, when I try and drive, the turbo doesn't go up. And I could hear the air start leaking out a hose out there, and you can actually see the truck not responding well to not having the turbo. A lot of people report black smoke out of the back, but it does in fact limp along after this happens, and the engine is very close to dying. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and start taking off this intercooler hose. I have a 7/16 inch wrench that I'm gonna go ahead and untighten this. I think it's plenty loose now. There we get the first little taste of blowout. You can see the part itself is completely filthy. This is a little bit harder to see, but basically I'm gonna have to thread a needle down here. Another 7/16 inch nut. Making it. There. Now, that's pulled off, and there is a sensor valve right there with a retainer clip. We'll go ahead and pull off. To actually take this clip out, we'll leave the wire tie in there for now. And that's it. I don't know why they didn't just make these in metal. Clearly they're having some issues with them. And then of course these pieces that all blew off.
I'm gonna watch you do this, is that cool?
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm going to go ahead and separate these. Wow. We can get to it. Go ahead and drop the temp sensor back on until it clicks. Put this back in its hold so it's good and tight in its slot. So let's go ahead and clip this retainer ring back in. Start her up. Watch that turbo. Hey guys, thanks for watching Waffage's YouTube channel on the replacement of an intercooler pipe on a Ford Super Duty F-350. If you'd like more videos, please like and subscribe.